Hello viewers, welcome to Elimu TV, a station where you watch and learn. I'm your tutor, Hilary Stirit. Today I'll be taking you through English Form 2, Lesson 5. Our topic will be on listening and speaking, and the subtopic will be on myths. Welcome. So I expect you as a learner by the end of the lesson, you'll be able to define a myth, describe the characteristics of a myth, and differentiate myths from the other forms of narrative or oral narrative. So we'll begin our lesson with the definition of a myth, and you can say, myths are stories or oral narratives that explain the origin of a group of people, phenomena such as death, and features like lakes, mountains, and rivers. They're stories that tend to explain the origin of a group of people, phenomena such as death, features like lakes, mountains, and rivers. Characteristics of myth, they always seek to explain the origin of mysterious things like life and death. Myths involve a supernatural character like gods and spirits. They don't have an opening and closing formula. Myths refer to things that happen at the beginning of a time. When we talk of myths, we'll still look on characteristics. They are always set in the early mysteries or magical world. Most of the myths are tend to set at the beginning or the onset of the origin of people into their world. They're closely related to religious practices and beliefs of the people. Myths are believed to be religious or to have a superstitious belief. Myths are always regarded as facts by their community of origin. Most of the myths which are they describe an origin of a community of people, they tend to believe they are true. Myths demonstrate that life is controlled by natural forces, which are normally considered instrumental in making things happen. This is because most of the myths are associated with supernatural beings and the gods. So most communities tend to believe that most myths have forces that control. We can look at an example of a myth. This is the origin of death among the Kalenjin in Kenya. So according to the Kalenjin, the number of hunters in their land had increased so much that the wild animals were being wiped out. These hunters decided to hunt all the animals off the plain. One day, as one of the hunters stopped to drink from a pool, as he was drinking from a pool, he noticed a reflection in the water. The reflection was very beautiful. It was a bird that looked like a cock. The feathers were very beautiful, but instead of having two legs, this bird had four. The head was large and had a blue comb. The hunter wondered what this bird was. He had never seen such a creature in all his life. He thought he was dreaming. He finished drinking water and rose to go, but then he realized that the creature was a reality. The creature moved and watched the hunter. The hunter in return watched the creature. Suddenly, the creature was strange. The hunter decided to aim an arrow at it. Perhaps the meat of the unknown creature was very sweet. He thought as he released the arrow. After the strange creature fell dead, there followed rain that was heavier than had ever been known before. The rain was full of thunder and lightning. Nobody knows where the hunter went. All that is known is that he never returned to his family. And apart from that day of heavy rain, people began to sleep forever. That is a myth that tends to explain the origin of the dead among the Kalenjin community. As the Kalenjin say, thunder got angry at the shooting of his innocent son, and so he sent heavy rain and death as punishment to people. Before the heavy rain, people had slept and woken up as usual. Thus, the long sleep known as death was caused by the hunter's curiosity. So if we look at the myth in the story, you can see that there are forces that control life, such as you can see in the story, the thunder was angry at the hunter who shot his innocent child, and thus caused a long sleep and death to the people. Having said that, you can check out the assignment. Can you try to define what is a myth? What are the features of a myth? And for much and more of these on myths, you can refer them to Exiling in English Students Book 2, published by the Kenyan Literature Bureau. You can also reach us on our SMS line as posted, YouTube Elimu TV, Facebook Elimu TV, Twitter @ElimuTV_KE. Bye bye. Till next time.